change at Hester's, it's also been a time to reaffirm what the organization has always been. A close partner and critical friend to public schools in Boston, focused on improving public schools through advancing our mission to improve the educational outcomes of all students. We're moving forward with our efforts at the classroom, school, and systems level, just as we've done for previous transitions over the last 16 years. We are not standing still. We are growing, deepening, and evolving our work to best meet the needs of the young people of our city, chiefly through supporting the adults who work with them every day in schools. I'll share a few highlights of Edvester's work and our approach for those of you who are new to us, and for those of you who know us well, a few updates. Edvester's is a school improvement nonprofit that combines strategic philanthropy, implementation support, and education expertise to help schools create the conditions for change. We seed promising ideas through direct grants to schools to pilot, test, and innovate around solutions to common problems through our School Solutions Seed Fund. We shine a spotlight on school improvement through the School on the Move Prize, I'll say more about that in a minute. And we scale efforts to close opportunity and achievement gaps through our three current strategic initiatives, beginning with Boston Public Schools Arts Expansion, our largest and most mature initiative, which has resulted in 17,000 more students annually receiving access to arts education during the school day as compared with 2009. We saw an example of that this morning through a partnership at Charleston High School, but the lion's share of that has been through public funds from school budgets, incented by grants that have allowed us to make this progress that we are continuing to push forward on so that 100% of students in the city have access to arts education. We are now working with 130 teachers in 19 schools to improve math practices impacting over 4,000 students. We're seeing promising results with students experiencing somewhere between a third to a half of additional year of growth as compared with what we would expect in terms of their increase in skills and knowledge. And lastly, we're in our first full year of implementation on our effort aimed at expanding career and technical pathways for Boston High School students. To that end, we've partnered with the DPS Career Technical Education Office to support pathway planning in several schools, and are working with district and city leaders to articulate a blueprint to guide career pathway development across the city, much as we collaboratively created a plan for arts education in the early days of DPS Arts Expansion. While the School on the Move Prize focuses specifically on Boston Public Schools, we work with all public schools in Boston, district and charter. Our School Solutions Seed Fund is zeroing in on math effort, deliberately integrate district and charter schools and learning cohorts to share best practices to yield the best results for students. And now let me return to what brings us here today, the School on the Move Prize, which is a celebration, but it's also an engine for learning through illuminating replicable strategies for school improvement. Each school's story uniquely reflects the staff, the students, the community, and the ecosystem that surrounds it. But these stories contain strategies that we can learn from. To document these replicable strategies used by improving schools, each year we engage in best practice research. The case study on last year's winner, the Mildred Askew 8 School, focused on a unique collaboration between the school, the district central office, and the Boston Teachers Union that was at the core of the school's dramatic turnaround. We released the case study this summer at a policy forum to advance the conversation on teacher-led school improvement and the power of labor management collaboration. Copies of this case study are available as you exit and on our website for your use, because we want people to use this information. I want to thank our longtime best practice research partner, the Rennie Center for Education Research and Policy, for their collaboration. On that note, I'd also like to recognize the entire Edvester's team. Everything you see today, every detail, and the prize itself, as well as our ongoing work in school, is a result of an extraordinary collective effort. It's a privilege to work with each one of my colleagues every day, and I want to ask them to stand and wave and ask that you join me in thanking them. solidified a number of key practices around collaboration, climate, culture, and rigorous instruction, but each adapted to meet the needs of their individual school communities. The McKay has developed a culture of leadership and empowerment, where teachers work collaboratively to take risks and experiment and share what works with their colleagues. Located in the East Boston, 60% of the McKay's 800 students are English learners, and the school has created a welcoming climate where all students and their families can feel safe and supported. At the Perry, a focus on equity and a commitment to continuous improvement drive teachers' work every day, empowering teachers to identify and implement the supports that each of their 250 students need to be successful, especially their most struggling learners. School pride is strong at the Perry, fueled by regular celebrations of students and staff that exemplify the school's core values of respect and hard work. The Muriel S. Snowden International High School at Copley brings an international focus to its 500 students learning on the school's campus, spanning three locations in the Back Bay. Using the International Baccalaureate curriculum as a guide, Snowden has created a consistent instructional vision focused on student-centered, cognitively demanding work to improve student learning. From the examples of these three schools and prior winners like the Mildred Avocado 8 and New Mission High School, whose leader we'll hear from later this morning, we know that deep and well-supported teacher leadership and shared ownership is a necessary component of school improvement. All of us in the education ecosystem, teachers, school leaders, system leaders, partners, policymakers should be focused on how to empower this and make it a reality for more schools. We can't be satisfied with the examples that we celebrate here today. We know we need to do more, and we need to do it collectively to make change possible in all of our schools. So I want to close by saluting these teachers, school leaders, and staff of the three finalists. With their unique stories, they serve as proof points and demonstrate what we all must work together to achieve. And I think they've already had some celebration because the late breaking news is that a generous anonymous donor has offered to double the prize of the two finalists who are not the winner. And I will turn it over to the first of three finalist videos.